Hello everybody, welcome to my first ever TEW stream on the YouTube channel. Trying kind of restarting the channel a little bit, not restarting, but like after long hiatus I had, kind of like rebooting it in a way, I guess. I don't know. It's hard to explain, but new series, first one TEW. If you can't tell by title, AEW. Pretty excited, mostly because AEW is one of my, if not my, favorite promotion. It's their home office. Got a couple things to look at. Off camera before I started this, I did some like edits, like pictures and stuff. So I'll go over the roster and go over some of the main storylines I got going right this second. Or start off, because in game we are like just before Blood and Guts, like it's in 2 days where I'm recording everything else. A couple days or so we'll see Blood and Guts and the results of the two darks. I'll talk more into that by the end of the video, but yeah, I guess I think we can just go with the roster. Let's just start off with the major guys. Alright. Chris Jericho. I think everyone knows who that is. The top guy in the inner circle, the main leader. He's gonna be, a big help in terms of, like, helping out. Some of the younger guys, like Sammy Guevara in the inner circle, among some other guys. Jon Moxley, the, I guess, hero of the promotion. He's our big baby face, the longest ever AEW champion. Excited to have him. He's gonna be doing good things. Paul White, he's our, big show basically. He got in. He's a commentator. I guess he's probably gonna be doing some occasional wrestling, but like, I don't know. I don't think I have any plans for him right now. He's pretty good commentating. Then you have Sting, the icon. He's near the end of his career, but he's gonna be the mentor basically of Darby Allin, kind of. You'll see. Like it's basically gonna be what he's been doing in real life, but I'll probably have my own spin on it. I'm going to try to be, as realistic as I can be, so I'm keeping most of like the relationship still going. So yeah, Sting and Darby gonna keep going. After that, you get to the, I guess, stars of the promotion. Christian Cage, who we brought in. From, after he came back from the Royal Rumble, he's a real life hasn't really done much. Christian Cage, one of my favorite wrestlers, so I'm kind of hoping I can do some good work with him, but we'll see. Cody, the Nightmare Family, or Cody Rhodes now. Jeez, I forgot that he got his name back. He's a white meat baby face. That describes him pretty well. He's been going out with that weird, like, factory civil war thing, so we'll be going into that here in a minute. Jim Ross, legend. Just great. He's gonna be announced for a little longer. I don't know how long till he retires, though, so we'll see how that works. Kenny Omega, world champion. Just, all around icon. MJF, just not much to say about MJF. Just probably the best guy on the mic, leader of the pinnacle, the usual. Pac, former Adrian Neville, he's got some just crazy skills, and I'm excited to, I guess, watch him or, book him. But he's crazy good wrestler in real life, and good to see him still. Good to see him in a top spot in AEW. I'm gonna go a little quicker now as we get down to the lower ranks. Arn Anderson, the coach of Cody, I guess, and Lee Johnson. Yeah, Lee Johnson. We'll get to Lee in a minute. Britt Baker, the non-champion star of the division. She's gonna be, up there in terms of, how much we need to use her. Cash Wheeler, just, him and Dax. Basically same thing, both of them, but they're both really good. Darby Allin, he's TNT champion, future big star, one of the big, push guys we've had. He's got a lot of momentum working with him, so he's gonna be, moving up quickly, I think. Then get to Doc Gallows, Elite. I don't know what I'm gonna do with him right this second. Probably mean some good. We'll see what happens with him. Like, I'm more interested in Carl Anderson, but it seems they're both in the same spot. Eddie Kingston, not much you can say. He's a working top mic dude. Yeah. Hangman Adam Page, he's gonna get King Omega soon, and it's gonna be a good brawl. Guest leader of Dark Order, kind of friendly Dark Order. It's kind of hard to explain, I guess. I don't know. We'll see what I do with that. Roberts and Archer, kind of not a main event, but like a second tier type thing. I do want to do more with Jake. I have plans, but with Lance Archer, I have my own little thing with him. I just, he's not gonna be a main guy. He's just gonna be like the upper mid carder kind of range. Matt Hardy, big money. He's, got a whole multi-member stable with him. He's good. Young Bucks, no way. They're both pretty good. Excited to have both men kind of carry the division. They're not EVPs in this universe, but in real life, they're, top. Top of, like, the, food chain in terms of, like, EVP, or Executive Vice Presidents. Miro, okay, Alexander Rusev. In real life, he won the TNT Championship. What happened here? We'll see. Orange Cassidy, best friends. You can't not love Orange Cassidy. Penta El Zero Miedo, or M. I like to say Miedo, but whatever. He's Zero Miedo. He's got it all with him. He's got the whole package. He just needs that extra push, I think. Speaking of Ray Phoenix, the more spot junkie kind of guy, he's also really, really, really good. I'm gonna probably change his picture at some point. I'm gonna say that now. I don't really like it. Maybe put in the comments if you see a person you want their photo to be changed. And I'll see what I can do. Sammy Guevara. Just, vlog star, Spanish God. And Taz, our other color commentator, he's gonna be a major part of the promotion. Cause you're gonna see in a minute. Team Taz coming out. So first up, Angelico and Jack Evans. I wouldn't consider them recognizable. They're kind of there, I guess, but they don't have momentum, really. I need to come up with something. Cause Evans isn't looking in real life. He hasn't been looking too good. While Angelico's kind of been stealing the show because of his technical changed his style to technical type style. Abraham Annie J, she's out for who knows how long. I think like 10 months in game, which sucks. Not much I can say about her. I don't know what I'm gonna do with her yet, so I'm gonna move on. Billy Gunn, King of Guns. Randy Rhodes, she's on maternity leave and she's out for like ever. So I'm gonna move on. Brian Cage, the machine. Machine Cage, figurehead of Team Taz, has a win over Adam Page. So that's probably gonna be the big feud coming out of that. Danielson and Kazarian, watch for life, you'll know. They just split up against the Young Bucks. I've got plans for both of them. Probably similar to real life, actually. The other two members, Chuck Taylor and Trent. Good team for the tag division and storyline. Like a road agent. I'm gonna skip over the road agents just because time purposes. Callus, huge important piece puzzle in terms of the Elite. He's kind of just the reason. He's the reason, like, you know, they're kind of hated as much, or they're kind of pompous, I guess. That's what I can say. Invisible Hand, best way to describe him. Dustin Rhodes, not much I can say. Legend. Earl Hebner. Is Earl, I don't even know if Earl Hebner still refs, honestly, in real life. I don't know. He probably should retire at this point. He's like old, so. First of, you know, the true Dark Order members, Evil Uno. Dark Order and all kind of guys. Excalibur, a true announcer, really, but it's considered a color commentator. Whatever. He's the main guy for all the commentary. Basically. After him, Hikaru Shida, the AEW Women's World Champion. Carry the division. She's probably gonna be done here in a minute, so I can put Bill on someone else for a second. Put the same person the whole time. It's just kind of like, ugh. She's had a really good long reign. I want to see her kind of more in the challenger spot. Private Party. They fell off a little bit, I think, because of the Acclaimed, which are gonna be next. We're gonna see them in a little bit, but yeah, you know, I hope they do good because they're both young and they got talent. Jade Cargill, just not much I can say. She's got it all in terms of skill. And you know, just like she needs to work on her microphone, I think, and she's getting better at that every day. So you know, it's just really good to see that we've got kind of a future star on our hands. Jake Hager is kind of boring, honestly. My referee slash road agent. I think he's like a road agent for us, but whatever. Joey Janela. Not much you can say. He's kind of taken a back seat for everything since he's kind of there. Does he still work for DC? Yeah, he does. Weird situation with him. I hope he does. I don't know what I'm gonna do with him. I'm still thinking about it. John Silver. The kind of star of the Dark Order. Like the rising star. I don't know what I'm doing with him yet. Because he's not gonna become like a champion. But like a mid-carder, that's like, you know. Kind of like a Jungle Boy type thing. Speaking of Jungle Boy, he's coming up next. But like, you know, always challenging for the top belts. I can see that. But like, not a champion, I don't think. Jungle Boy, this person, Jungle Boy is kind of not similar to John Silver. Jungle Boy's gonna become a champion. Like, no doubt about it. I have huge hopes for Jungle Boy. He's 23. I'm just, you know. Kip Sabian, in game, I don't think he's out with an injury. I know in real life, I think he is because of his hand or something. But like, yeah, I love Kip Sabian. Honestly, he's one of my favorite guys on the roster. I'm not gonna push him to the moon or anything. Just you know, he's gonna have a good spot in terms of like a mid-carder guy. Chris Statlander, another one of my favorites. She's crazy good wrestler, and you know, her being a faction is really good for her. So yeah, Luchasaurus. Not a lot of people like him. They like the gimmick, but not the actual like wrestling ability. Though in game, he looks like he's not terrible. So psychology is pretty bad. And I don't know. He's gonna be kind of comedy mid-carder. He's not gonna be as good as Jungle Boy. Marco Stunt. I'm sorry, but Marco Stunt is just he needs. I don't know. He's just way too small. Nyla Rose. She's gonna be pushed. I love Nyla Rose. Good wrestler. Good gimmick. I think they just haven't pulled the trigger on her. Unless they should. Ortiz and Santana. Same thing here. I have plans for both of them in my head. They need to be more prominent spot than they have been. Hobbs. Just beast. I hate this picture of him though. I need to switch that out. I got another one ready, but just the teeth, it just doesn't. Ugh. I don't know. It doesn't scream like a beat, like a monster to me. Or, you know, like a huge athlete. Ricky Starks. In real life, he's out for a bit because of an injury, but in the game, he isn't. I'm not going to add in, it's too late, but, you know, he's. I'm glad he's not injured because, you know, he's just, you know, really reliable, really good future. Just everything about him is nice. Scorpio Sky, AEW are messing up on him, I think. They're kind of like wishy-washy with him, like not going all in or not going all out. Sean Spears, you know, top dude, in the eight or top dude in the pinnacle. Stu Grayson. Third quarter. Tay Conti, she's really young and she split a lot of like the wrestling world. You know, I think she's, you know, fine. Like not from special, but like you know, I don't see why WWE Performance Center kinda let her go. Or WWE let her go. Blade Butcher, well, Bunny goes down below. Blade Butcher, get tag team. I don't know, there's not much to say. Thunder Rosa, just, she's good. that's me. And, you know, Tony Schiavone, he's been really good, I think. I don't know. Trent. He's, you know, kind of shook. He's a mid-carder kind of guy, and maybe like TNT Championship, I don't know. Tully Blanchard, the manager, Vicky Guerrero, manager for Pinnacle, and Nyla Rose, respectively, and then Wardlow, who's really good. Just like, I'm not fully. I'm gonna see what I can do with him, because I don't want to push him too quickly. Alright, so I'm gonna go really quick here. I only skip through major guys. Aaron Solo, he's, you know, factory. Abaddon, I have plans. She's gonna be slow built, kind of Jungle Boy style. Dark Order on Angels. Can't really hate the dude. Same thing with Reynolds. Bowens, Caster. We'll get to Caster in a minute. Bowens, I think, is really underrated compared to Caster. Caster, you know, has got that nab as a commentator, but Bowens is also just good. Anthony Ogogo. I'm trying to figure out what I want to do with him since I feel like the QT Marshall stuff with in real life Cody stuff isn't really working out with him. But you know, I want him to be good. Gun Club, the Bear Brothers, their photographs are really bloody and like, you know, I don't. It's not the image I don't really want to see. I guess it's not hardcore guys, but you know, odd deal. Big Swole, she's, you know, she was there, then down there. That's got to do more about Crohn's, I think. Crohn's disease and kind of that taking her out for a bit. And, you know, she's good. So I hope for the best for her because she's a really good pillar for the women's division. Not much I can say about him. You'll see more from him in the show. Pillman, Griff Garrison. I can't find Julia Hart, the manager that I just had on AEW Dark. She's not in the game, or database, I guess. So I'm kind of, trying to find a replacement, I guess. Cheerleader type girl, cheerleader type person, manager. Could be wrestled too, I guess. A pretty picture kind of like the job squad for our game. If you watch Dark or what you call it? If you watch Dark or Elevation, these people are, pretty picture are a known commodity. Colt Cabana, just a really good veteran. Gun Club, Danny Limelight. He's, well, I'm not spoiling anything. I've got a plan for him. Darius and Dante. I think Dante's one injured. Did I get that right? Say where he gets injured. I'm not fully used to like the mechanics yet about where I can find like physical injury. Here? Here? No. Whatever. You'll see here in a minute for medical. Ethan Page. He's partnering up with Sky. Pretty good team. Way to the soul. Can't hate Way to the soul. Come on, man. Griff Garrison, Green, but Brian Pillman's with him, so I feel good about him. He's also like a. It's weird seeing him on like Sammy Guevara's block because he just you don't expect his like personality to come out there. I guess I don't know. Just from what he looks like, I guess, or in ring. JD Drake, pretty picture, the enforcer. Couple. Young boys, I guess, or young girls, well. Lee Johnson is going to the moon. Just telling you guys now. Not quickly, but just look at those stats. Oh my god. He shouldn't be that good on the microphone. We haven't. Did Leva beat wrestle anymore? I know she does, like, weird stuff where, like, Brandy and, like, but. I don't know if she wrestles anymore. Hirsch. Oh, Rising Star. Look. Just Luther. Matt Sydal. His brother is not in the company right this second for whatever reason, so I'm bringing him in. Matt Caster. Can't tell he's one of the guys that changes the photo for, but. Mike. Charisma. I don't know what to do with her. Because in real life, she hasn't had done anything since, like, the tag team tournament. For the women's tag team tournament, so. I'm not sure. She might be one of the guys I let go, because I just. There's not much for her. I guess, an extra body. And one fish won't hurt. Naka. Naka. Nakazawa. Mike Posse. The man. The big referee. Nick Comoroto. He's, I'm certainly, just a crazy looking dude. Penelope Ford. I think she should be doing more because she's really good on NXT and she just hasn't done enough. I don't know. Pretty Peter Avalon. God bless that mustache. 10 Pete Preston Bonds. He's the better of the two versus Angels. I guess, but they're both good. QT Marshall. Not much I can say. God's gift. Okay, he also ran won a Ring of Honor contract putting out prospect. Is he like a prospect match? Since like, Vinny and Matt are the company. I don't know. It seems weird. I don't know. Rebel. Or Rebel. Not Rebel. Red Velvet. Riho. I don't know what I'm gonna do with her. Ryan Nemeth, Perry Picture. Also pretty good. He's really underrated, I think, but whatever. Serena Deeb, she's injured. Whatever. Serpentico. Serpentico. John Cruz, Jay Cruz, Eddie Cruz. Just yeah, he's I don't know why he's signed. Like why he got signed, but he's not why he got signed. I know why he's good, but like I don't know the reason why I thought he was good. Shanna, I'm not sure what's going on with her. She's like in, she's out. You need to be, Sean Dean. Saying kiss, partner for Joey. That much. Bunny hasn't done that much. Yuji, she even manages. She should be a wrestler too. I don't know, whatever. Yuji Nagata coming in for that match. Fun. All right, a few things we need to go first. Storylines. These are not done. All right, there's a lot more I think I want to do, but like it's gonna take time. But these are just the initial storylines for life. Best friends with Death Triangle, which is gonna intersect with the Omega Long Reign one down here. Then Darby and Sting, Sky Page, and then Miro and Tarjun are kind of in it since Miro's lost the title. Family Factory, Cody versus QT. That's basically it. Inner Circle versus Pinnacle. Yeah, we're gonna be starting off with a Bloods and Guts match for this feud. So, all fun. Miro, and then Archer, Darby. Archer and Robert's doing that weird thing with like Sting kind of liking him. But like Archer's like, eh, maybe, no, yeah. Like he's can't make up his fucking mind if he wants to accept it or not. Women's title, Baker's obviously number one left. That she needs to beat. Paige and Cage, Tegan and Taz. And then, the Elite versus John Moxley, Eddie Kingston. And then their main members of the SCU, basically. You want to stop anytime to see if any of the guys that I glossed over. You go ahead. That's wrong. Alright, anyway. For shows, I'm going to see if I can do the dark shows after so I can show you guys them shows like that. Like episode after, so episode 3. But if not, I'll just show you guys before I do. Because I want to do dark elevation and just normal dark like before or like on its own separate thing for sure. You don't see me actually booking it or whatever. And then medical, not much I can I guess swells out for a bit now, but like whatever. Jay, she can still work angles. I can't do any surgeries, which sucks. Women's division is kind of, three top people. Four, I guess, you count Kong. And then Brandi Rhodes. Okay, Brandi Rhodes, whatever. Cutler, he's did some of his eye socket, he's out for a couple months. Darius Martin did something to his knee, he's out for a bunch of months. So that means the 19-year-old's gonna have a shock, good for him. And then John Silver, he needs to re-separate, so re. Re-separate term, but like bring back a soldier together. Anyway, I don't know, it's not much, I guess we could do like figurehead stuff. Nothing here, Cody and John, Cody and Kenny, which is I kind of realize that probably wouldn't make sense. Do I need to show you anything else? Signs, promises. Night one I'll put in Dark Order. So I went to the I went up training camp a little bit. Oh, and then signings. I'm gonna bring in some of the dark people that you usually see on Dark. First off, restarting Ryan Nemeth. and bring in Mike Sydal. I don't know why he isn't, because he's, full-fledged guy at this point. After that, Marty Cock, or guess this game, Marty Martinez, the Gray and Alanis duo that you keep seeing, Diamante, but she goes by a different name in this game, and then bring in some other guys like, Joshua Bishop and Richie Slay, which I thought looked good, so I was like, all right, I'll try him out. Larry Morales, you've seen, he's been like everywhere. Dark, Willie Nightingale, or Viperous, the I think White Chocolate or Milk Chocolate tag team. I think they came out of one show, but I'll bring him on since they look good. Andrew Jordan, Renee Michelle, BSK, and the Dudley Brothers or the Hughes Brothers. I need to get pictures for him. I'm gonna get some pictures for him. BSK, just normal. If you've watched Dark or Dark Elevation, you know what I'm talking about now. Go in more detail about those guys later, but yeah. That's it for this episode. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you all next time for AEW Dynamite.